So you're looking to insulate your brick house with foam insulation, but you're not sure, should you insulate the stud cavity or the Wythe cavity on your brick home? Let's talk about it. Well, at this point, some of you are probably wondering, what is a Wythe cavity? Or some of you might even be wondering, what is a stud cavity? Don't worry, I'll break it down really quick for you guys. Stud cavity is your wall assembly, and this is a traditional, it's usually, again, made of studs. When you think about a house that's being built and you see the framing of the house up and you see the studs lined up vertically around the outside walls, that is your stud cavity. This is typically where insulation, plumbing, electrical, all kinds of things are. That's what makes up your outside exterior wall. Now, for a brick home, what is a Wythe cavity? This goes by many different terms, but essentially it is a small cavity between layers of brick or masonry block and the stud cavity itself. This cavity can be anywhere from a quarter of an inch to 2 inches sometimes, depending on the construction. This cavity goes by many different names: Wythe cavity, weep cavity, drain cavity. There's, depending on your region or your contractor, you may have heard many different terms for this cavity. But again, it's essentially that little bit of space between the outside brick, whatever type of masonry it is, and that inside wall assembly. So which one should you have the foam installed in? Well, there's kind of pros and cons to both. Let's talk about the stud cavity first. Your stud cavity is going to be the most common avenue for foam to be put in. The reason is because it's the most uniform and it's the most regular thing that contractors are going to do. Generally, you're always going to want to insulate your stud cavity. It is more normal and it's more common for contractors to want to do. That's typically where insulation will go. And when it comes to a brick house, the install is a little more streamlined when you are installing foam into the stud cavity. Your drill pattern is a little bit more uniform. It's, again, the process is just a little bit more seamless when you're installing foam into that stud cavity itself. When you're talking about the Wythe cavity, it gets a little more complicated because the drill pattern is a little bit different and how fast you install the foam is a little bit different because, again, you are putting foam into a smaller cavity. So there are a little bit more variables that go into it. But generally speaking, stud cavity is going to be the most common way to insulate a brick house. This also gets you more foam because that cavity is typically thicker, which of course does give you more thermal resistance or R value, and does help a little bit more when it comes to actually having that wall assembly itself, again, having an overall higher R value. Now, there are certain times when doing the Wythe cavity is the most sensible thing to do. For example, if your stud cavity has something in it already that doesn't allow for foam to be put in, or maybe the stud cavity is not accessible, or in some cases, there isn't a stud cavity. Sometimes you have brick on top of brick or block on block, and there isn't an actual stud cavity sometimes, even in residential situations. So that does happen. And in this instance, again, the Wythe cavity is a good option. One very big pro to insulating the Wythe cavity over the stud cavity is that you have a continuous layer of foam behind that brick, and that continuous layer of foam is a really good way to help establish your building envelope. Keep in mind, when you install any type of insulation into your stud cavities, you have studs that break up that insulation. So this will inevitably lead to some thermal bridging. We accept this as normal in your normal residential stick-built house because there's no way around it. You have to have stud framing, so you're going to have those breaks in the insulation around the outside of the house. Whereas in the Wythe cavity, again, there are no studs. This is actually more closer to the outside of the wall assembly versus your actual stud cavity. So again, you can allow yourself to have an entire layer of foam around your home. So this is a very good way to establish that building envelope and stop any air infiltration from coming in. The downside, obviously, is that you have less overall insulation, so you have lower R value, so a little bit lower thermal resistance when it comes to conduction. Again, that's kind of the pro and con. If you do have a situation where the Wythe cavity is the only option, are you getting a little bit lower R value or thermal resistance? Yes. However, kind of the flip side to that, what kind of makes up for that con, is the fact that you have that continuous layer throughout, which is a major benefit, again, when you're thinking about your building envelope. So if you have a brick home and you're ready to take back the control and comfort in your home, whether it's through insulating the stud cavity or the Wythe cavity, go to our link below to our Find a Dealer page, where you can find your local RetroFoam dealer today. This is the Professor of Foam reminding you that building is a science.